devices such as cyber phone and stuff. And all these things are big challenges to add. I will encourage those of us who are beneficiaries. I will also encourage those of us here who are technologically inclined to please. I want to emphasize, please, those who have this opportunity, use it positively.
After that period, you were feeling the conversion. I had an idea with the
yeah. I think this will happen today. Before you come and speak, we have some stakeholders here who are coming to share a lot of ideas concerning business, digital media, and what its impact is on the economy and our industry. The opportunities it can give you to get jobs, and the opportunity it can give you to start and manage your own business.
Now, that is just by the way the mindset. After you've drawn the mindset, you set a goal and then you achieve the gap.
So there are so many variables you can do to enable you to arrive at what? Your destination. Does that make sense?
Yes.
Good. So the first and foremost is to have the right mindset. Prepare your mind that you have to get yourself involved in so many things that can lead you to where you are going. And one of them includes crisis management, which I will touch on it. Because in your quest to become who you want to be, you will need this challenge.
That's true. Digitization. In that, you will need probably to sell your products online. I would normally make the point that young as we are, you can be at Sungurungu, you can be at Volga, and still do exporting without necessarily having to travel and through Kotka International Airport. What do? All you need to do is to take a picture of a basket, put it on an Instagram, and you are in the global space within the export ecosystem. So, ladies and gentlemen, for us at Export Promotion Authority, we will always reiterate the necessity or the importance of digital media.
Are you ready? Alright,
cool. But for me, I didn't know until about 4 weeks ago when we were able to maintain it and then to keep it. Now, as a result of the cultural change and then the cultural integration, the nuclear families went at first. The other ones were those in the older generation. We don't even know of the practices that we don't document it. It was passed down by oral means. And so this all has this information together. Now it's digital media.
Podcast and publishing. And our team plans providers, specialists, technology providers, and so much.
Who feed us with the information? We need to go to them and get it and place it. Price those that are readers as those who are going to tap and use them to share our content. And then we require our give backs.
Our funding. We need it to take.
Capital generated on our YouTube platform, we make money from that we're going to use for the maintenance of the system that we'll create. We have Adam Nimatu, who is thank you.
But then, they are bedeviled with what? They can be given access to information, access to what, finance that are unemployed and underemployed, just so that, and blogging, just so that we can share ideas and platform. It will also, you can use it on your phone, on your tablet, on your computer, business model. This is our favorite team. We are in Africa.
Invite the team lead, Sidney Martin, to give us a keynote address.
I'll say we do our inspiration from my next thing, Paul Simmons, who says that a team is not the people who work together. A team is the people that work for a passion. So if you have a passion and you can mobilize people to work with you, then you are a team. And if you have a passion and you can have people to work with you, then you are not going away. Coming for this today is not for me, but I think it's for the team. And I just want us to appreciate them. Let's clap.
True. This person is no other person but my own friend and brother, Derek Doe. Let's give it up for him, Derek Doe, to get. She is a deputy branch manager. Ladies and gentlemen, with a thunderous round of applause, let's welcome Ekua Safua to get to the stage. Charlie. Ladies and gentlemen, with a resounding round of applause, let's welcome Mr. Salifu Suleiman. Let's give it up for him.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. My name is George Kumamoto, a co-founder of Growth Media, and these are my co-founders. We have Dente Philomena as our digital marketer, Lydia Copper as our photographer, Ntamini Ernestina as our creative writer, Jidudu Gapeto as videographer, and sound designer Shadrach Bekwe. So let's move on. So Growth Media is dedicated to help the growth and development of small and medium enterprises, that is the SME, through proper branding of business and product. So this we've come about with the name due to the problem that we have found in the town, which is we are going to help small and medium enterprises to get a branding system for their businesses. Let's work on.
So ladies and gentlemen, with a clap, let's welcome First Step to mount the podium to give us their presentation. Yes, your name? Is on.
My name is Jamesi Xavier. I'm here with my team members, Janka Charles, Abigail Sombu, Nyamadi Olivia, Adetimebel, and Jimama Mebu. First Step, we are a news, education, publication, and media entity with focus and specialization in education and career guidance. After conducting our market research, we come out with the following problems.
The gap in our education system is causing youth and graduates unemployment.
Okay, when we go to our solution, we will provide a digital platform where we connect our professional business and also career counselors and mentors to meet our target audience.
Now, so with our innovation, we use photos, videos, graphic design, sound design, content creation in
Okay, so let's continue with our products. We have education and job orientation. That's what we want to offer: content creation, job referrals and placement, news and article publication.
This is the third group. Bismarck, you are good to go.
Thank you very much. My name is Bismarck Law, as mentioned earlier, and I'm the sound designer, and my sister here is
photography. Xavier Mensa.
Okay, Xavier Mensa. Actually, we are not two, but because of some inconveniences, two of us will present on behalf of our colleagues. The name of our group is Creative Life. The name of our group is Creative Life, and we have to focus on large picture printing. We have a lot of photographers around. From our market survey, we've realized that there are people in town, Dambai here, Karachi, Chinderi, Pandai. There are a lot of photographers, but where to print the pictures is now the problem.
A piece, perfect piece. So you have 5 minutes for your presentation and you have 10 minutes for the questioning. You, judges, you're good to go. Your time starts
ladies
now.
And gentlemen, good afternoon. We are the United. And I am Lodo John Asiome. We have Madam Fusina, Madam Irene, Madam Sikapis, Mr. Emmanuel, and Mr. Daniel. And as we are here, our company deals with social media market services. We deal service with local artisans in Oti region. If you look at Oti region now, we do a lot of artisans in Oti region, but it only stay in the region. It doesn't go far, and people around Oti region doesn't know what we are entitled to in the Oti region. So as we move on, our problem or what we see is local artisans, we are here to market their product and services on social media platforms.
That's most tourists see when it comes to the website to visit our main tourist site.
they come and they don't have places to stay at affordable prices. They come and they don't get to socialize with their natives because they stay in hotels that limits them. And the site has called MEN, so they didn't make it quite yet. And then I told you, so they are now all my offices. The hotels around the place are half of it. Yeah, then what's the advantage we have? The advantage we have is that we are focused on voter registration. So MEN that I spread my problems just my price was in voter registration. We are focused on voter registration. We are putting out all this data. Trying to make sure we solve that problem. Mm-hmm. Affordable,
yes,
we
are
trying to
make
everything
affordable.
Actually, not
hotels,
nice hotels, but it's too costly, so
affordable. I think it's a wonderful thing you guys plan to do. We are trying to solve a problem which we think that the solution is quite innovative. So I don't have any question. I'm happy that your problem didn't come from your room.
To create attention, bringing aspects of startups and SMEs, and they want to offer a sense of creativity, yet affordable for startups to transfer to put their business ideas. So please, let's work on them.
Yeah, so what our LSP is trying to accomplish is, the problem is that startups focus on building rather than reaching their audience. So what we are trying to accomplish is that we'll help them reach their audience wherever they may be. And there are already other businesses who are competitors. They are already into this advertising business.
So in the process of expansion, we will probably move from just advertising to blogs, maybe kind of promotion, planning. Tourism side of the machine, digital media training. So basically, we'll try to recruit the younger ones who are behind us so that they can also get the digital training skills.
How many of
us
saw this season in the Mozambique? In 2019, Africa recorded nearly 70 million tourists. And Ghana has a little over 1 million coming in. What has been apportioned to the Volta Reef? The story in Ziyaki would not be the same story in Hobankwe. It would differ. And so we are exploring all angles of tourism in every community that we visit, and then we will project it out there to our audience.
For the award, we'll give the first team a winning plaque and a cash amount of money. Thank you. For the troubles. And then the second would give plaque, third plaque, and something small.
Thank you.
good afternoon and welcome to the local startup investment pitch summit held right here in Ho, the Volta Regional Capital. And proceedings here were just brought to an end just a few minutes ago. We had several teams pitching their ideas for our judges to actually peruse and then give them feedback. So at the end of the day, we've had our winners. We've got the Everett or JWAP, actually the JWAP team clinching the victory, and we also got Everett as the second runner, the first runner up. We also got Beta as the second runner up, and then Fan Sue Generics actually going for the third. So for JWAP and Everett, they get to start the incubation. And then for the other team, we have a wonderful package including paid internship at an organization for them. So at the end of the day, I think everybody was okay. All right, so I have with me here the managing director of Who Not Hub, one of the implementing partners of the LCIPS, to just give us just a few thoughts of his own on his general impression about the program. So welcome.
Thank you. I think we've done very well in terms of the preparations and planning for the program. And you could see the numbers who turned up today. And I'm very, very excited that we've been able to put this together. I'm also impressed with the startups that turned up today. Four teams. And you could see the quality of ideas they have. So I think in general, I would say that it's been a very good program.
Run us through the journey, you know, till this stage. How did it start? How did it go? And, you know, the note on which we are ending today. Are we ending on a high note or on a low note?
Okay, so we are actually not ending. This is just a bridge that will get us to the second phase of the program. Yeah, so we began this program some 7 weeks ago. We had to call for applications and people applied. We shortlisted, we interviewed, and then we got the people to the training. This is part of a partnership between Ghana Tech Lab under the Young Africa Works program funded by Mastercard Foundation. So it was intense training for 6 weeks, preparation to put that pitch together, and then also the D-Day, which is the pitch day. Now the pitch day is just an event to give us which of the teams would go into incubation and which of the teams would go into internship. And you realize that the pitch day is not the end of the program. So we have two more events that are coming up, which is the internship, which is a platform for the trainees to practicalize their skills. And an incubation for those who are having ideas, will support them with all the toolkits that are necessary to build businesses. So we are not ending. This is just a phase or a bridge for us to get to the next phase.
The great architect and the managing director of Who Not Hub, who actually saw to the successful organization of the pitches today, the summit today. We'll be talking to a few more participants. We'll be talking to judges. We'll be talking to the teams that participated to get a feel out of what happened today, and also from some former cohorts for them to tell us about their experiences. All right, so you're still watching Who Not TV. We are still at the sidelines of the local startup and investment pitch summit. We've got some of the contestants, one of the contestants from one of the teams that pitched earlier today with us. What's your name?
My name is Ellie Newton from Team Beta Innovation.
Beta Innovation. All right, so tell us about today's pitch. Is this your first time pitching something?
Absolutely, yes. This is my first time pitching, and then standing in front of a crowd like this is my very first time.
So tell us about the innovative idea that you presented today.
Okay, so my team worked on the idea of being an advertisement agency. So we work around the clock, and then our target market is startups. So we shoot adverts for them and then promote their pages. That is what basically we are about.
All right, so tell us about the process, you know, the overall process and your impressions.
Okay, let me begin from when I joined the program. So personally, I had to forfeit something that will bring me money. I was fortunate to have been selected to be a census official, but along the line, I had to drop in and join the program. And personally, I think that my expectations were met, and then the whole process was very good. Our tutors were very good. They had time and patience for us, and then I just want to applaud the organizers and everyone that took part in making this a success.
That is wonderful. Okay, so we now have Faustina Seka. She's one of the leaders of the Evert team. One of the leaders of the Evert team. They are runner-ups and they are the new incubation entrants. So just a quick question. Faustina, how are you feeling?
I'm feeling excited. Mixed feelings, actually. Because at a point in time, I didn't think that we would actually be take the second place. Because the way the questions were coming, like the follow-ups, the way the judges were punching holes into our entire pitch, it was like, my goodness. And moreover, seriously, we had a challenge because we didn't really prepare so well, as in for the presentation, practice how we would actually go by it and all that. Because this morning, us at 4 a.m., that was when we went to sleep, and then we got up around 7 a.m. and we have to continue working on the pitch deck. So while we were on our way here, that was when we were trying to put thoughts together in our heads and all that. And so when the first team, second, third went, and the way the things were going, my goodness, trust me, I was really nervous. And I believe that some of my colleagues were equally nervous before mounting the stage. But then, all in all, it's been great.
All right, so we are still at the sidelines of the Local Startup and Investments Pitch Summit. And we've got the main players here, the King Kongs, the main architects, the winners. They are here. Jawab, talk to me. How are you feeling?
Yeah, we are so excited. Like, we didn't think this would happen. We didn't expect it, unexpected. But we are very grateful to God and to all our trainers for bringing us this far.
What idea did you pitch to get it?
Okay, so we pitched about getting accommodation for tourists who visit the Volta region among the natives so that they can be able to socialize with the people when they come and not just be limited somewhere else.
Now, talk us through your journey up to this point. How did you start all this?
Okay, so actually, I was interested in photography, and then I saw this opportunity, so I applied, and by God's grace, I was selected. So coming here, actually, I didn't even end up doing photography. They made me see something else I was very good at, which is creative writing and blogging. So, like, it was a lot of training and skill, like, acquisition here, so it's been a long journey, full of benefits, full of training, things that I wouldn't have known if I were not here. Things that I wouldn't have, like right now, I know so many things, like I have experienced a lot of things. I'm grateful.
Alright, so I know that you also have a dynamic team who also in diverse way played their part in getting the whole team here in clinching victory. Now tell us about, you know, your experience at Honod Hub.
Okay, so at Honod Hub, like I'm kind of sometimes shy or scared to relate to people, but then really they've made everything comfortable. They made us feel like we're a family. They relate to us well. When you have a problem, our trainers are going to really listen, like, to you, like, one-on-one, help you with your problem. So being at Honod Hub has been like, I've gotten a new family. It's been very beautiful.
You're moving on to incubation. So tell us about your next journey. Are you carrying the same energy into the next journey?
Oh yeah, I'm carrying this big energy. Actually, I didn't have this much energy when I was about to pitch. I was just hoping that I do well. But now I've gotten this much energy. Like, all the people getting the first position means that they believe that this idea could come into fruition, that this idea is a great one. So I've gotten more energy and I'm taking this energy with me into the incubation stage.
So we are actually very excited for you and for your next journey. Thank you very much for speaking to us. Okay, so we are bringing proceedings to an end here at the whole Municipal Assembly Hall. You've been watching the Local Startup Investment Pitch Summit. We are very excited for all our teams, and we are excited for the journey that they are about to embark on, both those on the employability track and those who are going into incubation. So for Hono TV, Jemima Achivos.
Des milliers de mots doux sur des pare-brises envolés, numéros composés.
Before we get started, I would like to express my sincere appreciation to God Almighty, our partners, Ghana Tech Lab, WorldBank, MasterCard Foundation, Ministry of Communication, and all other partners, including the media in the Upper West region and other key stakeholders in the region, who generously helped us make this event to come together to become a success. We couldn't have done it without you. In today's gathering, I would like us to focus on drawing our collective experiences, knowledge, and wisdom towards building our dear region, Upper West.
Has become a national security threat as a country, and this part of our country, that is the northern sector. What do you think is not utilized enough? That is why we have these youth, graduate youth coming out every year. We have a chunk of graduates that are graduated into the system. We have every year from all the tertiary institutions. They come and they are all sitting down waiting for the government to employ them. Do you think we have a space that these youth will shift their attention so that we can utilize very well the digital media that we have found ourselves in?
Thank you, Madam Morris. You know, I'm people a gender activist, so I have interest in the person as a CEO, because it's one of the major areas that I do. So I'm a man, but ladies here, I'm equally your sister. I'm not saying that a man and a woman at the same time, but the work I do, you can see my sister as well. Your CEO can bear with me in that regard. Boris, besides the environmental and cultural underpinnings that further weakens women's pride and zeal to participate, we the men are equally a problem in a woman succeed. You have a girlfriend, you promise to marry, she's an entrepreneur. But because you are doing other engagement, you don't want to support her, post her businesses in your WhatsApp status. Yes, is it fair? So that's one aspect. So they have that naturally low esteem. And two, the moment a woman becomes active in social media, we the guys have just sent a girl as an arrogant girl who want to go to show off. The other thing is that the ladies equally have a problem. Everywhere they will go and they want to post. Every new club they will buy and go and stand on. I've never seen a young man stand on road to take picture. But you see women, even in the morning, in Southern School, they will be just standing on the road to take picture to show that they are this. You have a problem with your boyfriend and you want to continually update your face with everyday pictures to still show that, yes, you still have fun, you are still there, you are very beautiful, you are punching yourself. So we should also encourage them in as much as that we are part of their problem, but they themselves are not helping themselves. Because why would you can see a lady would have an issue with a man and they can use the whole man to every 30 minutes in the picture, whatever she's doing. So that will take a room to go to a restaurant. Something and ask them someone, they will just sit quietly and take a selfie and go and buy garri again for a man to know you are now going to graduate. So that will not help. And so, back to your question, we need to create opportunities as a country. As far as we have not limited the right to vote, we are not cutting the right to admit us in our colleges, in our universities, then we need that. But the problem we have in Ghana, it is the political economy. Government court vote will tell you that your problems will be solved. We can fix it. Government cannot solve your problem. alone. So what we need as a country, as individual, is you need yourself valuable. If you are university, you don't have value. Excuse me to say that. If you go to the they will tell you that you are nobody. Because your whole certificate of first class cannot be a collateral security. Is that a serious country? So a woman go for loan, look at a peasant, there is nothing for us to use as collateral security. Why? You have gone to university, you are first class graduate. Your own existence cannot guarantee you to and your government cannot also give support. Enter into that world of entrepreneurs. So all is about branding. So that
so hello Mr. Rai, thank you so much for making it to today's event and we are really honored to have you here. But I would like to ask, what do you really have to say about the event? What do you think about the event, today's event?
I think it's really good to see Ghana Tech Lab trying to really promote digital skills and innovations in Ghana. And basically most of the people that came to give their pitches, I think they had brilliant ideas, even in a short time. And I think generally the ideation of the whole thing is a very good one. It's an excellent one, yeah.
What do you really think about the ideas that came, that were brought up today?
Okay, so basically I think the general goal was to get people that are really experienced in digital media. Yes, but in terms of a problem statement which I really found interesting was for lamps, rent space. I think it was a very beautiful idea.
What do you think about the next phase for Ghana Tech Lab in digital media?
Okay, as a company, I think you guys are doing a very good thing. I would want you guys to maybe focus on actually recommending or having a course in which people can actually log on to your platform and then learn some of this passcodes and then see this kind of videos and then learn from them. I think it's good to see people like you trying to push digital in Ghana, and I think it's a very good one in the right direction. Yeah,
it's an honor being part of the event, and I like the fact that it hasn't been a norm, but I realize that more of these events, and this one in particular, trying to get businesses and people who are into digital media, having the events catering just for them, and it's a very good idea, and I hope there's more of it coming.
So I would like to find out from you, what are your views about the ideas that were brought up today? Generally, what do you think about the ideas that were brought up today?
They are very good ideas, full package. Some of them probably need a little bit more help with their presentation, but at least for the first three, the few of them who made it to the top three, they have very good ideas and presented very well.
Okay, so congratulations, Lamps Media. I'm very proud of you. I mean, coming second at the second edition of the I cannot start a pitch summit. I'm really proud of you. What did you really put into yourself, working together as a team, into your ideas that you believe brought you this far?
To ask someone that we knew we were going to get this far, well, everybody came here hoping they are going to be winners, but they wouldn't expect to be the second runner, the first runner up. It was teamwork that got us this far. And then adhering to the trainers' rules and then advice that they gave us, that really helped us this far.
Okay, so I'd also like to find out from you, how did you find the event, like today's event in sum total?
It was nice. This whole venue, the setting, the conference room, it was really nice and it was really relieving and calming. The event has been inspiring, listening to other people. The first session they had of the panel discussion, it was very, very informative and educative, and we loved it. It's been a very good event organized by GTL.
I'd like to find out from you, as a startup, having come through a digital media based program, what are the next steps for you as a startup?
I found it a good idea that GTO decided to have an incubation right after this. So our next step is going into the incubation, putting in our extra and maximum best efforts to make sure that we succeed in the next pitching level. That is what we're going to do.
Okay. So then to my very last question for you, what are your final words to GTL and the partners with whom you are here today and whose efforts have brought us this far?
Yeah, actually, we want to say we thank and appreciate GTL and
their partners for such a wonderful program. They've actually broadened our horizon. We've learned a lot, and I mean, the opportunities given us and the other generations, I know whatever that comes from our product will end up benefiting others. So we pray they continue organizing such programs for the youth.
Ladies and gentlemen, help me with an applause.
So congratulations, Team Teleosis. I'm really proud of you. Thanks. I think you guys have done well coming this far. I'd like to say, did you guys really think you were going to win? I mean, what did you put into, what work did you put into it that you think brought you this far?
Oh, okay. So I'm thinking about going to win. I think our name itself speaks about it. Word Teleosis is actually a Greek word, which means perfection. It also means a pace setter.
How did you find the pitch event? I mean, the sum total of today's events. How do you find, how did you find, you think it's innovative enough? Do you have any comments to give the organizers, anything for us?
Looking at the organization of the program, I think it was just on point. Me, I think it was just on point, and I really enjoyed, I mean, from the panel discussion, I mean, everything that went on in here, I really enjoyed it so much. So I think, I mean, God be chief bless GTO. I mean, very much for this organization. And also God richly bless the partners who helped GTL make this program a success.
So what are your next steps as a startup that has emerged winners of the second edition of the Powerware Startup Summit?
All right, so I think the next step is to still work on our skills, because I think what will give us the lead in the market now is the unique skills that we are having. So we need to polish those skills, we need to work on them very well. And then we also need to understand the market very well. So the next step is going to be more about studies, I mean, skills upgrade, and then understanding, I mean, the market very well.
Thank you so much, Ghana Tech Lab. Thank you all. Thank you to all our partners for making this event a fruitful one. Thank you so much, Teleosis. Enjoy the rest of the day.
I'm Laila Al-Hassan, and I believe digital media is the future.
Digital media is not just the order of the day.
I believe digital media
is the future, yeah.
We are here to present the ideas.
For the first position, we have Bra Africa.
My name is Mohamed Abdulhamid. I'm CEO of Zobi Ghana. It's an incubator focused on small startups, giving them technical support.
Great. So please, what are your impressions about the startup summit we just had?
I think it was great. Nice to see how people take simple ideas and transform them into sustainable businesses. Of course, just like a lot of startups, they are now starting, so they have their own setbacks. But like it was discussed, some of these setbacks are also opportunities for growth for them. And whilst they explore to augment these setbacks, you see that avenues for sustainability also open in that regard. So I think this has been great, and I'm sure these startups will go very far with the level of support and collaboration they are getting. I see some of the startups even finding partners even right here before they leave the four walls of the tech lab. So I think this has been great.
My name is Abdullah Issa.
Okay. What are your impressions of the just ended Accra West Startup Summit?
Okay, the ideas, I must confess, were great ideas. Really, really interesting, you know, especially the storytelling aspect, because in this day and age, storytelling is everything. Once you are able to carry out or express yourself, you know, and then someone hears it, the person is easily able to buy it. So what I would like to tell the participants is that they should work on their startup. They should have a lot of do a lot of research. It doesn't end here. The fact that maybe they didn't get the feedback or the investor, they shouldn't rest. They should do a lot of research. They should ensure that they work on their craft and build their team more. And then most definitely they'll get where they want to go. Thank you.
Thank you. How does it feel to have won the Accra West Startup Summit?
It's very exciting. Actually, we weren't expecting something like this, for it to become a winner. So we being the winner of this startup, we are also waiting to go into the incubation pool. So we are very excited and happy about this pool.
What's your startup name?
We Travels.
Okay. How does it feel to have come this far in the Accra West Startup Summit?
It was a bit challenging, and you know, since from pre-tech where it was all women, and now to a point where it will mix up with other people, women and men. It's interesting. Just not a team with four women and one gentleman, we've come this far. And then, you know, he also encouraged us to come this far. So it's very interesting to come this far. And also it's something to show the young ladies out there that we can do it. It's not just for the men, but we women also can put gun on the map.
I'm Pamela Botekwe. Please tell us about how your journey has been with the startups this far.
Well, it's been a promising like journey. It didn't start easy. I remember for some of the ladies here, they started from our Digital Media Pre-Tech training program. So to have them come from there all through to the main base program, being the Digital Media Base program, to turn out to even be winners and first runner-up of this program, it's encouraging. It tells me that there are more potential out there. Like, there's more potential out there to do more for people. Anybody would believe in them, take them on, and have them train up in our training programs. Yes, please.